Hello friends, today we will study the performance analysis for an algorithm. What do we mean by the term performance analysis? After we design an algorithm, or rather before designing an algorithm, we should consider what is an impact of this algorithm on the performance of the machine, or when I design a program, how will my performance be affected? The fundamental concept for performance analysis are, the first one is the dynamic memory allocation. Now, what do I mean by the term dynamic memory allocation? In computers, when we store any memory or when we store any variable, as soon as we declare it, it gets stored randomly in the memory. So we have to be very careful when we are designing an algorithm or when we are declaring a variable, how we declare that variable. We should know how much space that particular variable is going to take, as we should not allocate more space to a variable which will be rarely used in the program, as it will affect the space complexity of my particular program. And the second important factor is recursion. Now, what do I mean by the term recursion? Recursion means continuously using a set of code by itself. It is known as a function calling itself again and again, is known as recursion. This is a very basic fundamental principle of programming. Performance analysis is based upon the dynamic memory allocation and recursion factor when we do the algorithm design and coding. Now, the performance analysis goes, there are problems and algorithms to solve them. The problem and the problem instances have to be considered. Now, what do you mean by the term problem and problem instances? When I take an example of any real world problem, then the problem occurs in which atmosphere or in which environment has to be considered, and what are the various factors that affect the instances for me to gain a desired output for that particular problem have to be considered. Let's take an example. Sorting of a data in an ascending order. From a large data set of numbers, I have to sort the data in ascending orders. Now, if we consider this as an example, and when we try to solve, or when we try to analyze an algorithm, there are many algorithms for sorting which are existing. And so we define this as problem is sorting, and the problem instance is sorting of data. Here we can consider a few numbers as 2, 3, 9, 5, 6 and 8. For this instance of sorting a data, I have to sort them in ascending order. The various algorithms that are used are bubble sort, merge sort, quick sort, selection sort and many more. Now, which is the best algorithm to solve this problem and how do we judge? So, for considering which algorithm needs to be solved or which algorithm I need to consider, we will study the performance analysis basis of time complexity and space complexity. To begin with, we will see what is space complexity. Now, space complexity of an algorithm is defined as the amount of space or the amount of memory it needs to run and compile the program. When I say the amount of memory it needs to run and compile the program, it takes into consideration all the variables that are used for defining and compiling a program. Space complexity is the specific amount of temporary storage required for running an algorithm. Computer and the compiler does not always take the complete memory or the secondary storage. It uses the temporary storage which is required for running an algorithm. We do not count the storage required for input-output, that is, the statements that we are using to print the input statement or the output statement. That is, the working prototype does not consider or is not considered while considering the space complexity of my program. Space needed of an algorithm consists of two components. Now, what are these two components? Let us see. The two components are the fixed static part. Now, what do you mean by the fixed static part of an algorithm? It is an independent of characteristics, that is the total number of inputs and the outputs that I have. If I have two variables, then input will have two variables defined, that is the static part of my algorithm. And this part includes the instruction space, that is the space that is required for coding. Now, the space for simple variables, space for constants, and the fixed size component variables are considered and is considered in the fixed static part of my space complexity. Let CP, that is CP is the constant or the static part which is defined for the space required for the code segment, which is known as CP, is a static space complexity of my program or an algorithm. Now, the second part is considered as the variable dynamic part. Now, what do you mean by the term variable dynamic part? That consists of the space needed by the component variable whose size is dependent on one of the particular problem instance at runtime. Now, what do I mean by runtime? Runtime means that input that I take from the user. User can input any size of the variable, or it is also considered for the reference variables. So it is defined as a space needed by the reference variable and the recursion stack space. Let SP be the space for the dynamic part of my variable. The overall space required by the program in space complexity is given as SP, that is space complexity, is equal to CP plus SP, that is the constant part and the dynamic part. For a particular example which is shown over here, we have taken an example of a simple C code. It starts with hash include stdio.h, void main, which is the main function. In this case, if we consider, we are declaring four variables, int, that stands for integer, x, y and z are variables, and sum is a third variable or a fourth. Integer, x, y and z, and sum is a fourth variable which is used to store the sum of all the three variables. Printf, enter the three numbers, is a non-executable variable, a non-executable statement, so no space is given for this particular statement. Scanf is a statement where I scan the values of these three, and sum is equal to x plus y plus z. This is one statement which has the addition of three values and the result is stored in sum. And printf is again a statement which just displays the output. If we consider the space complexity for the program, there are no instant in characteristics, and the space needed for x, y and z and sum is independent of the instant characteristics. That is, all three values and the sum are independent. The space for each integer variable is 2. We have 4 integer variables and space needed by them are 4 into 2, which is 8 bytes. So SP is equal to CP plus SP, that is the constant value and the static value. So constant value variables are 4, which means I have a constant value of 8, but there is no dynamic part in this program. So my space complexity for this particular program is 8.